This is the first tutorial in our data formatting series, where we are following the transformation of a dataset from its original state to adhere to Darwin Core. The dataset we will format to Darwin Core is a fictional intertidal survey where we have assessed percent cover of macroalgae in quadrats along a transect in an intertidal zone. This dataset has been documented in an Excel spreadsheet, so we will be working with Excel. In this video, we will learn how to create event IDs. Before we make any changes to our data sheet, we should make a working copy. We want to keep the original data intact so we have a reference to go back to. So let's copy the entire data set, create a new sheet, paste, and this will be our working copy. So the first thing we want to do is create two blank columns, one for event ID and one for parent event ID. Now, the next thing we want to ask ourselves is, what is the smallest granularity event for which we have information? To help us understand, let's look at a pictorial example of the sampling scheme. So because this is a transect data set, we have quadrats along a transect with different station visits. So the quadrat samples are our lowest level of events. The quadrat samples are nested within the transect event, which is nested within the station visit, which itself is nested within the sample year. Thus, we see quadrat samples are the lowest level of events, and each of the higher event levels are considered parent events for the event directly below. So the transect event is the parent event for the quadrat samples, the station visits are the parent event for the transects, and so on. So knowing this, we will construct our first event IDs for each record corresponding to the quadrat events. We can see that each row already corresponds to a quadrat event, so that's fine. To construct the event ID, we will concatenate information from the dataset itself. So we will use a concat function in Excel. We will include the dataset name, the station name, and then we're going to add an underscore here to separate the station name from the transect number. Oops. We want another underscore to separate the transect number from the quadrat number. So when we hit enter, our event ID looks like this. We will apply this formula to every row in our data set, and you can see that there's a unique event ID for each quadrat within each transect. Next, we want to make sure our IDs will not change. So what I'm going to do, because this is a formula, we're going to select the whole column, copy it, and then we're going to paste. We're going to paste as values. So instead of being a formula, now it's the value. So it will not change if the information in the other rows change. Next, we have to do the parent event ID. We know that the quadrats were nested in the transects, so our parent event ID for the quadrats are going to be associated with the transect. Again, we're going to use the concat function to concatenate the dataset name with the station name, an underscore, and the transect number. We'll apply this formula to all rows. Make sure we copy and then paste as a value so that formula does not change. So already you can see that the event ID for the quadrat is a subset of the event ID for the transect. Now, speaking of the transect, we have to make sure there are event records for all these parent events. So that includes the transect, the station visits, and the sampling year, or the cruise, the project name, whatever is your highest event. In this example, it will correspond to 7 new rows. Now we have to populate all the other information for each parent event. Well, we know they all belong to the same data set, so we can copy that information. And before we move on to filling in the event IDs, let's make our lives a little bit easier by making a new column called event remarks. Here, we will write the type of event in order of highest hierarchy to the least. So that will be the sampling year, the station visit, which occurred 3 times, the transect event, which also occurred 3 times, and finally, the quadrat sampling. So we'll apply this to the rest of our rows. Now, starting with event IDs, for the transects, we know that the event IDs of the transects are the parent event IDs of the quadrats. So we can copy that information directly. Now we will fill in the information about the station, as well as the transect number, 1, 2, and 3. Of course, the parent event ID for the transects will correspond to the station visit. So we can concatenate the dataset name with the station name. And this gives us the parent event ID for the transects, as well as giving us, very conveniently, the event ID for the station. Now you can see that when I pasted this, it's looking for a reference. I'm going to undo, and that's because we forgot to copy and paste it as values. That's why it's very important to do that. Now we can copy these values and paste them as event IDs for a station visit. Now, the parent event ID for the station visit is simply the sampling year. So in this case, it corresponds to the dataset name. This also gives us the event ID for the sampling year. So the interesting thing about using event tables and event IDs in a hierarchical manner like this is that it can help reduce redundancy in the data. We don't need to repeat information like dates or coordinates, depth, and so on if we don't have to. So for this data set, we can see that the coordinates were only taken at the station level. There are only 3 unique coordinates. So what we're going to do is copy these unique coordinates and paste them to the associated station visit. And now we can delete all other coordinates so they are not repeated. Doing this can help reduce errors because the more data is repeated, the likelihood of introducing errors increases, especially if you have to go back and fix a value later. In this way, if we had to go back and fix the longitude or latitude, we would only have to fix it in 3 potential places. The same with the dates. There are only 3 unique dates, and they're associated with the station visit. So we will copy the dates associated with the station visits. And we can delete the rest of these. So with all of our event and parent event IDs added, the next thing we want to do is make sure our coordinates and our events adhere to the correct standards. We'll look at this in the next 2 videos.